And now we have the second in a four-part series called Bel Canto Voices. It's introduced by Patrick O'Connor, who's talking this week to the great American mezzo Marilyn Horne.
Must have been good.
Well, I don't think anyone who ever heard it will forget that. Part of Malcolm's aria, Mura Felici, from Rossini's La Donna del Lago, the New York City Opera Orchestra conducted by Richard Bonning, and sung with astonishing virtuosity by our guest today, someone who, well, who is Bel Canto? Marilyn Horne.
Well.
So let's hear Stignani now in the Act One aria from Rossini's Semiramide, a 1938 recording.
Oh,
Giorno from Rossini's Semiramide, sung by Ebe Stignani. Giulietta Simeonato, singing Dei tu Bell'anima from Bellini's I Capuletti e Montecchi.
Again.
Let's hear Conchita Supervia as Cinderella in the Rondo Finale from Rossini's La Cenerentola, recorded in 1927.
Palpita. Non più me Satan
Conchita Supervia, in her very first recording, the Rondo Finale from Rossini's La Cenerentola, recorded in Milan in October 1927. Supervia was the Rossini singer in the 1920s and 30s. She died very young, in 1936, and after the war, her mantle fell, to a great extent, to another Spanish singer, a soprano, Victoria de Los Angeles. She became one of the greatest Rosinas in the Barber of Seville. She recorded the role twice. I know you admire her very much.
Well, she was another person who was absolutely one of my idols, you know. These early LPs that she made, and I mean, I just wore them out in the early 50s, you know. And I was in school, and, you know, if ever she came to Southern California, I would race to hear her recitals and things like that. I just loved, and still do, the sound of that voice. Oh, well, I was in Barcelona on the anniversary of her 40th anniversary of her debut, and the classical music station there played her voice 24 hours, and I had a cold, so I was really in bed for 24 hours listening to De Los Angeles. I died and went to heaven. The most extraordinary gift I could have had that day.
Well, let's hear Victoria de Los Angeles in Rosina's aria from Act One of The Barber of Seville.
Thank you.
Victoria de Los Angeles, as Rosina in Rossini's The Barber of Seville, her first recording of it, made in the early 1950s. Let's hear one of Skipa's most famous recordings, Ernesta's aria from the last act of Don Pasquale.
Amarmi in vita.
Skipper as Ernesto in Donizetti's Don Pasquale. So let's now hear Pavarotti in the aria O Muto Asile from Rossini's William Tell.
Thank you.
Luciana Pavarotti singing O Muto Asile from Rossini's William Tell with the Vienna Opera Orchestra conducted by Niccolò Rescigno. Well, let's hear your famous recording, the Cabaletta, the first act duet from Semiramide. But you're going to have to pronounce it because it's got too many vowels in it and I can't do it.
Alle più care immagini.
Thank you.
Cavatina from the Act One duet from Rossini's Semiramide. The soprano Joan Sutherland duetting sublimely there with the mezzo Marilyn Horne, who was Patrick O'Connor's guest in this week's Bel Canto Voices.